for those who have more than one granny front part. I will explain to you what to do. Well, I will not crochet the complete cardigan. I will only make the two grannies to show you what to do with the front parts. So I will attach the yarn in the chain one space and make my single crochet there. Don't forget that one. Most people forget it and then your stitch count won't be correct. Then, please remember that when you're crocheting on the correct side facing, that your working chain is on the right side of your double crochet, not on the left. Only when you turn, your stitch will be on the left of your double crochet. While we are chaining, crocheting now on the correct side of your work, the working chain is on the right side. So perhaps you need to move the single crochet a bit up to see your stitch here. So there's number one. I have to make 14 up until the top. So that's number two. That's number three. And come directly back with what to do with all the tails. Well, I put it aside my work. What you can do as well is put your hook through and pull it up. Go from the other side, put your hook through and pull your yarn through. Other side and put your yarn through. And here. Through as long as you went up till your tail is gone. Well, I leave it here. It's enough for me. So I have now 1, 2, 3 single crochets. It's number four. Number five, number six, number seven, number eight, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, and 14. Now I'm at the chain one space. There I make one single crochet in. And again, your working chain is for the next row is on the right side of your double crochet. So perhaps you need to move it up a bit. And here it is. So 14 down the hill. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, and 14. Now you're in the opposite side from your starting point here. In this single crochet space, you put your hook through. So there, put your hook through and go to the next one. Here is your chain one space and put your hook through as well. Then pull the yarn through both and single crochet finishing. Then again, you need to go 14 stitches up, 14 single crochets. Make sure that you're at the right stitch to start. So here's your chain one, which you made two grannies together. Here is your working stitch. So there, it's number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, and 14. I'm in the top again from the chain one space from the granny. There I make one single crochet. Here's your double crochet and there perhaps you need to move it up a bit. Here is your next chain. Now 14 down the hill. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, and 14. And don't forget to put your single crochet in here. Well, I only make these two grannies, not the complete 6 or 7 or how many grannies you have. I only make these two grannies because this is the most important part which you have been struggling about. So here's my chain one space. I make one single crochet. Now, I chain one and I turn my work. So you have the back side now, the wrong side facing. As you all know, I leave these tails in there, so that way I know this is my wrong side. Now, what does the pattern say? Chain three, double crochet three together and two together. Well, I made my chain one here only, so I start directly in that space and I make one unfinished double crochet. In the next stitch, I make one unfinished double crochet. And in the stitch after, I make one unfinished double crochet. Now I've got four loops on my hook. I'll put the yarn through. Now you have to make two double crochets together over this and this stitch. So make one unfinished double crochet and in the next stitch as well, unfinished double crochet. Got three loops on the hook, pull the yarn through. Now I have to count 10 stitches up, so 10 double crochets up the hill. That's one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and number 10. And here is my chain one, a single crochet in the chain one space, and there I make my one double crochet, chain one, and one double crochet, all in the same stitch. Now go 10 down the hill. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 9 and 10. Now I have to crochet four double crochets together. So this one, I skip 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then 6. These 2s, 8 and 9, you will put together. So let's start together. First stitch, one unfinished double crochet. Second, one unfinished double crochet. Third, fourth, fifth, sixth, and seventh, you will skip into the eighth. One unfinished double crochet, and in the next one unfinished double crochet. Now I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 loops on the hook, and I'll pull the yarn through all 5 loops. Done. Now 10 double crochets up the hill. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Here is my single crochet which has been made in the chain one space. There I make my one double crochet, chain one, one double crochet. Show you how it looks like this. Then you go 10 double crochets down the hill. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 7, 8, 9, and number 10. Then 2 double crochets together, 1 and 2. Got 3 loops on the hook, so 2 unfinished double crochets, and then pull the yarn through, and then 3 unfinished double crochets. Hey, I've got 2 stitches. No, here's my chain one, and that one counts as well. Don't forget that one. So the first unfinished double crochet, the second unfinished double crochet, and the third in the chain one you made in the previous row, also an unfinished double crochet. Now I've got 4 loops on my hook, and I'll pull the yarn through, chain one, and turn. Third row, So I pull out. So chain one, chain, make three double crochets together. So one unfinished double crochet, the second unfinished double crochet, and the third unfinished double crochet. You've got four loops in the hook and pull the yarn through. Now 10 double crochets up the hill. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and number 10. Now I'm at the chain one space again. There I make one double crochet, chain one, and another double crochet in the same stitch. Now we go 10 double crochets down the hill. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and number 10. Now I'm at the valley here. You see one stitch, the stitch which made the four double crochets together, and the next. This one and this one you would double crochet together. So it's two double crochets together with one skipped space, skipped stitch in between. So make one unfinished double crochet, skip this one and go directly into the next. There you make one unfinished double crochet and pull through. Well, that's what you will be repeating. 10 up the hill. In the chain one space, you make one double crochet, chain one, one double crochet, 10 down, and the last three together. Don't forget, you're chaining one to turn your work. Well, I just finished this row, the third row of the body piece, and then we'll start off with the front part, crocheting them together up until the chain one space here. The last three stitches, as I said, must be crocheted together. So here is the first unfinished double crochet, the second unfinished double crochet, and the third is the chain one that you made to turn your work around. There you put it through, see, two loops on the hook, and then pull up, unfinished, you've got four loops on the hook, and pull the yarn through. Fasten enough, I will do it like this. Chain two, cut my yarn, got a nice clipper here, pull through, pull on it, and then wrap your fingernails and put those two chains, move them up towards your work, but pull on this one as well, so like this. Now you've got a really tiny, tiny little knot. When you're crocheting, you won't feel it again. To make sure that you don't have any sewing in of your tails at the end, I turn my work, take my crochet hook, pull through the two loops and pull the yarn through. Then from the other side underneath two loops and pull the yarn through and keep on continuing up until you have no tail left. When you crochet the other row around, you will crochet automatically around this tail. Little tail, so that way it's stuck and you don't need have to you don't need to sew in all the tails at the end, because most of the time that's the most irritating part of this. So well, I think that's enough for me. Put it up a bit. So front part, think about it, this is your right front part. Here I will attach my yarn and we will start up with decreasing only on this side. So pick up my yarn again. There it is. Come on. So here I made a little drawing and I posted it on the Facebook page, so please see into that. That way you will make the decreases on this side. So we start here and don't put your needle hook here. Why? You're crocheting on the good side facing. So this is not your working chain. The one is here. There is your working chain. So there you need to attach. I'll show you. I've explained before, when your double crochet is on this side, here is your working chain, not there. So this is not your working chain, here is your working chain. So you need to put it in here. And there we start off with first attaching the yarn. And then it says three double crochets together. In this one you make the first unfinished double crochet. So here, unfinished. Then in the second, which you all are thinking about, this is my first loop. Well, it doesn't. Here's the two loops, pull through, unfinished. And the third one. Since you're working on the correct side facing, your working chain is always on the right side of your stitch. I've got four loops and hook, I'll pull through. Now, 10 double crochets up the hill. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and number 10. And since we have to make two granny's front part, I will make one double crochet, one stitch as chain, and one double crochet in the top, in the chain one space from the previous row. Now I will go 10 down the row, 2 together, 10 up, and here I stop. So let's get started. Number 1, number 2, and please remember that you're working stitch on the right side of your double crochet from the previous row. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and number 10. Now I have to crochet two double crochets together, so this one, skip this one and into that one. So what we will do is make one first unfinished double crochet in the first stitch, skip the next stitch and into the stitch after, you will make another unfinished double crochet like this. You've got three loops on the hook and pull through. Now you go 10 up the hill, that's number 1, number 2, number 3, number 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Now, since you're on the correct side of your work, you will make two double crochets in the top. That's number 1 and that's number 2. Here you have one double crochet, one chain, one double crochet. But if you take the half, you always have to put one more from your half. So when you have three stitches, you will take two. I've got two stitches here. Now, chain one and turn. Chain one and turn your work. So, since I have now one stitch extra, I will make 11 double crochets down the row. Because in this row we do not increase or decrease on this side. So that's number 3, number 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11. Now we're in the valley, we crochet two together, so in the first, second you will skip, and in the third, so first stitch one unfinished, skip one and in the third one on one unfinished double crochet. You have three loops on your hook, pull the yarn through. Now crochet up the hill, 10 double crochets, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and number 10. One double crochet, chain one, and one double crochet in the chain one from the previous row. And now we have to go down the row, but the last three stitches must be double crochet together. So 1, 2, 3, 3, and you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 stitches left. Why 9 and not 8? Because most people think that, because you're adding up here one stitch. That's why you have only one stitch less when you 3 double crochet together in the beginning, and in the top you will make a V-shaped stitch. So chain one double crochet and chain one double crochet. So I will go back up until the beginning. There I am. My last three stitches. That's one unfinished, second unfinished, third unfinished, and four loops on the hook, and pull the yarn through, chain one and turn. Again, 3 double crochets together, one unfinished double crochet, the second unfinished double crochet, and a third unfinished double crochet, 4 loops on the hook, pull through. Now we go up, up towards the V-shaped stitch in the top. Double crochet up, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, because we had 3 double crochets together, you've got now 8 double crochets left in a row. In the top you will make 1 double crochet, chain 1, 1 double crochet, and then you will repeat again 10 double crochets down, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and number 10. Here at the valley again, this and the third, first and the third again together. So one unfinished double crochet, skip one stitch into the third, you will make one unfinished double crochet, you've got 3 loops in the hook, pull the yarn through and up the hill. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And in the last one you will put 1 double crochet and another double crochet. So you've got in the last one 3 double crochets and 9 double crochets in between. Chain up one and turn. Now you take the stitches as you see them. So double crochet in all of them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 and 11. We're in the valley again. So one unfinished double crochet, skip one stitch into the next, one unfinished double crochet. You've got three loops on the hook and pull the yarn through. Then we go 10 double crochets up the hill, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and number 10. We're in chain one space again, so you make one double crochet, chain one and another double crochet, and then we go down the row. Since we have made three double crochets together on this side and we add more there, then you have one stitch less to crochet. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and number 7. Now three double crochets together, so that's one unfinished, the second unfinished, and I've got here my V-shaped stitch from the chaining turning chain. You make also an unfinished double crochet. You've got four loops on the hook, pull through, chain one and turn. Now three double crochets together, so we start again, one unfinished double crochet, the second unfinished double crochet and the third unfinished double crochet and pull through. Now we go six up the hill, that's one double crochet, the second, the third, the fourth, the fifth, last but not least the sixth. We're in the chain one space again, there you make one double crochet, chain one and one double crochet. Now we go again 10 down the row, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Then we're in the valley again. Again, two chains together and skip the middle. So that's one unfinished double crochet, skip one stitch into the next, one unfinished double crochet. Now you've got three loops on the hook, pull the yarn through. Then we go up the hill, 1, 2, 3. Five, six, seven, eight, nine, and number 10 is here in the chain one, plus two more double crochets in the last stitch, that makes three double crochets in the last stitch and nine between the together and the three double crochets. So chain up one and turn, take the stitches as they come, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 and 11. We're back in the valley, so we crochet two together with one skipped stitch. So one unfinished double crochet, skip the next into the third unfinished double crochet and pull through. And we go 10 up the hill, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. In the chain 1 space, 1 double crochet, chain 1 and 1 double crochet. And now we go down the row, double crochet all the way, 1, 2, up to the last 3 stitches, 3, 4, and number 5, the last 3 stitches must be 3 double crochets together. So, 1 unfinished, the 2nd unfinished, and the 3rd unfinished. 4 loops on the hook, pull the yarn through, chain 1 and turn. Every row you've got 1 stitch less. At the end on the good side row you will add up 3 stitches in the last 9 double crochets. So after the V-shaped, the 2 double crochets together in the valley, you will go 9 double crochets up, and in the last stitch you will make 3 double crochets. The row on the wrong side, you will crochet the stitches 11 down the row, 2 together, 10 up, V-stitch, and the leftovers plus 3 double crochet together. You will repeat this up until you have only the V-shaped stitch left, and then you're approximately on the shoulder seam already. So, I will finish this off and I will show you later. So, I've done my rows. I'm at the last row of decrease. I'll show you what's happening. I make 1 unfinished, the 2nd unfinished, and the 3rd unfinished double crochet, 4 loops on the hook, pull through, V stitch on the top, 1 chain and 1 double crochet. This is how it looks like. So you repeat up to there and 1 row back. And then you're done. This is the front part for a 2 granny front. So, now the question, how about the left front part? Well, you start at the back side, so you turn your work around and start here, on this side. Then you're on the wrong side, so you will start on the left side of your working stitch. So, then you start here, go up, down, up, etc, etc. So you do exactly the same as you've done here, on the right front side, but then on the incorrect side. You will start on the right side and make the same stitches as you have done here. Then your front parts are finished. So you have to imagine like this is your armholes fit in here nicely. Most of the time with these rows, some people have to add 2 or 3 more rows here. Then you can just repeat between the lines. So start here with 3 double crochets together, down the row, 2 together, 9 up, 3 in the top. At the back side, you will start off with 11 stitches down, 2 together, 11 stitches up. Then you turn up to the correct side, 3 stitches in the top, 10 down, 2 together, 10 up, 9 down, 2 together, 9 up. In the last one, you make 3 double crochets in the last stitch. So actually what you have done here on this side, you repeat here and there. So you start off with 3 double crochets in the same stitch, 9 down, 2 together, 9 up, 3 double crochets in the last stitch, turn your work around and take the stitches as they go. So you make 11 double crochets down, 2 together, 11 up, turn your work, 3 double crochets in the top, 9 down, 2 together, 9 up, 3 double crochets together in the last. Repeat this up until this point, and this point can reach, exactly this point, sorry, this here, can reach your shoulder seam, which, or in the middle of your shoulder where normally the seam of your clothing is. Then you're correct, and then you make the fill ups here. So I hope this helps you guys a bit more. Good luck, and see you again. Bye bye.